Proper navigation is a crucial element of any website design. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create a beautiful interactive navigation bar. Let's take a look at the project's demo. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. I have already created index.html file. Within that, it's just a basic initial code. Now let's change the title. For the title, I'm giving Futuristic CSS Navbar UI Design for Modern Websites. And for our icons, I'm taking help from the website called iconify.design, and it provides the lots of icons library, and you can choose any one of library as you prefer. I'm taking this library called Material Symbols Light by Google, and with the help of that search bar, you can search any specific icon, something like house, and you can see based on your search, you'll be able to get different versions of icons. You can click any one of them, and at the bottom, you can see you'll be able to get different codes based on your technologies. For me, I just want to take the HTML and SVG. Before using any other code, first of all, you need to import this script to your HTML code, so you can copy that whole code. And now within that head tag, I'm just pasting the same script code, okay, along with that different attribute. Now you can just copy the code for any specific icon. And also let's create a style.css file. And just below the title tag, I'm giving link for our style.css file. Now let's create different HTML elements that we need for building our navigation bar. So for that, within the body tag, let's create nav element with class name navbar. Within that, I'm creating onOrderList, and now let's create list item with class name navItem. Within that, I want to create anchor tag with class name navLink. Now within that anchor tag, let's keep the icon. For that, you can just copy that HTML code. You can see you'll be able to get the span tag with class name iconify, and we are using house icon, okay? Just below that, let's create another span tag with class name text, and within that I'm writing home. Now you can just duplicate the same code. Now let's give another icon. I'm searching for the shopping cart icon. Now you can see there are lots of different shopping cart icon. I'll choose this icon, okay? And once again, just down there, you can just copy that code and paste it within our HTML code. For the text, I'm giving orders. With similar process, I'm adding two more list items with different icons and text. Now with the help of LiveServer extension, let's look at our result in our browser. In your browser, now you can see you'll be able to get different icons with different text. Now in our style.css file, within our root-shooter class, I'm creating different color CSS variables. You can choose any color scheme. Based on that, you can create your own different color variables. So these are very basic code, okay? So based on your project and your preference, it may change. So I'm not explaining you all about this code, okay? I'm just changing some font size, font family, you know, something like that. And also for our body tag, I'm just giving some background color, and I'm using the same CSS color variable that I have declared in our root pseudo class. And with the help of this three line of flexbox code, you'll be able to bring your content exactly at the center of your browser. And now you can see everything is at the center of your browser. Now let's style this nav element with class name navbar, under list, different list items, and so on. Okay, for our nav element with class name navbar, I'm giving width of 41 rem. For the height, let's give 7.5 rem. And let's give the background color of that CSS variable called navpg. Similarly, I want to give some rounded corners. For that, let's give border radius of 3.7 rem. Similarly, I want to change font size to 1.4 rem. And also now you can take the same three line of flexbox code and paste it down there. And once again, that will bring your content exactly at the center of your nav element. As you can see, you'll be able to select this text. So in order to prevent that, you can give user select to none. Now let's style another list that is within our nav element with class name navbar. For that, let's give width of 32 rem. And by default, it gives the padding. So let's give padding to 0. And I just want to remove that bullet points. So for that, let's give list style to none. And now let's give display to flex. Similarly, for our list item, let's give width. For the width, I want to give equal number of width for each list item. So for that, I'm just creating another CSS variable, nablist-width. And within that, I'm giving the same 32 rem. And now within that width, you can pass the same CSS variable. And now you can just copy the same width and paste it down within our list item. And now you can wrap all this code within the calc function and divide by 4. Why 4? Because there are 4 different list items, so I want to distribute it equally. If you think it's complicated, then another simpler approach would be, instead of creating this CSS variable, within that calc function, you could give 100% and divide by 4. So one of you might say, if you want to distribute equally, why are you using this kind of complicated process? When I'm using Flexbox, absolutely, you're right. In order to distribute it, I can easily do that. But there is reason behind it. Later on, I'll tell you why. Now let's style that anchor tag. Let's change that blue color text to something else. And also I want to remove that underline. So for that, let's give text decoration to none. Once again, let's give display to flex. And if I give flex direction to column and align items to center, then you will be able to break down that two elements and bring it to center. Similarly, I want to give some gap. For that, let's give 0.3 rem. Now let's change size of our icon. As you can see, different icons, text, class name, iconify. So you can style that same class name. I'm giving width and height of 2.4 rem. Now, whenever you are giving class active for your anchor tag or the nab link, at the time, let's give some specific styles. And that class active, that will be controlled. I mean, like, that will be dynamically generated with JavaScript later on, okay? So now, for the anchor tag, whenever you are giving class active at the time, for our icon, let's give translate. For the x-axis, I'm giving 0. And for our y-axis, let's give minus 2.4 rem. And also I want to change that color to primary. And now you can duplicate the same code and bring it down there. Now instead of that icon, let's change our text color. So for our text color as well, we'll give the same orange color. And also now when you hover that anchor tag at that time, again, I want to give the same text color to that orange color. As you can see, we are changing property. So in order to provide that smooth transition, you can duplicate the same code and let's give transition duration of 0.5 second. You can remove that hover pseudo class. And also, as you can see, for our icon, we are changing different CSS properties. So again, let's give that same transition duration for our icons as well, okay? And also now when you hover anchor tag at the time, I just want to change that icon's color as well, okay? So again, once again, we are giving that same primary color. Now let's create another element. I'm calling it as navbar indicator. So I'm just creating div with class name nav indicator. And within that, I'm again creating another div with class name box. So now let's style these elements. So for our class nav indicator, let's give the width. For the width, I'm giving the same width that we have given for our different list items. So you can just copy the same code and paste it down there. And now you can duplicate the same code and bring it down there. Now for the class box, I'm going to give width and height of 7.2 rem. And I'm going to give background color of that same nav busy variable. And now you won't be able to see any kind of changes. It's because we are giving the same background color. So for our class nav indicator, let's give the position of absolute. And also we need to give now relative position for its parent element. So for the parent element, I want to take it as that class navbar. So for the class navbar, let's give position of relative. And let's take it to the top. So for the top, I'm giving minus 50%. And also, I want to give that transition duration, so you can copy that same code and paste it down there. And also, let's make that box to short color shape. For that, let's give border radius of 50%. And also, I want to give the border. For the width, let's give 0.8 rem. For the border style, let's give solid. And for the color, I'm giving the same color that we have given for our background color, which was the secondary CSS variable. and let's make it horizontally centered. So for that, for our margin, I'm giving top and bottom to 0.5 rem, and for the left and right to auto. Now, whenever you click any specific nav element at the time, we just need to move our nav indicator to that specific position. So for that, we need JavaScript code. There are very few lines of JavaScript code, so I'm just using the internal JavaScript. So just above the end of body tag, let's create a script tag. And within that, let's create constant variable. I'm creating the variable name navbar, and I'm assigning document.querySelector, and we're selecting the nav element with class name navbar. Okay, this element. And also, we need to select all the list items or the nav links. So for that, once again, I'm creating another constant variable, nav links, and I'm assigning navbar.querySelector all. So we're selecting all the anchor tag with class name navlink. As you know that within our navlinks variable, we are storing all the navlink. Now with the help of that for each method, you will be able to iterate all the navlink. And for each navlink, I'm representing it as navlink. And within that, once again, for our each navlink, I'm going to give the click event. For that, I'm writing dot add event listener. So we are listening to the click event. And for the second parameter, let's give the function. And within that, I'm writing there this, that this keyword represents the exact nav link that you have clicked, and I'm writing dot class list dot add. So we are adding the class active for our nav link that we have clicked. Now in your browser, you can see whenever I'm clicking any specific nav link, you will be able to keep that class active for each nav link. But I just want to keep the class active only for that nav link that I have clicked. So next time, whenever I'm clicking another nav link, I just want to remove the previous active nav link. For that, you can write something like navbar.querySelector. So now you can select the nav link with class name active. Okay, don't forget to keep their dot. And once again, we are taking the same approach. I'm writing dot class list dot. This time, instead of add, we'll give remove method. And with the help of that method, you will be able to remove that class active from our previous clicked navbar links. Now in your browser, you can see you will be able to keep class active for only those nav link that you have clicked. But still, now you can see our nav indicator that is at left side. It is not moving along with our current active link. So as you can see in our installer CSS file, I have given their width, and that width was the same width that we have kept for our each nav items. So now, in order to move that indicator, we can get rid of all that complex calculations. Now simply you can write navbar.querySelector. So we are selecting the div with class name nav indicator. So that div, okay. And I'm writing dot style dot translate. So we just want to move in x-axis. Therefore, I'm writing is equal to, and within our backtick, you can just give their dollar curly bracket. So we are just moving in our x-axis. So for our y-axis, let's keep it to 0. And for our x-axis, within that dollar curly bracket, along with that each nav link, you can pass another parameter index. So with the help of that, you will be able to get the exact position of each nav link. You can write index, and you can multiply with 100, and just outside of that curly bracket, you can give percent. So that represents the CSS unit, okay? And in your browser, you can see whenever you are clicking any specific nav link, that nav indicator, it adjusts its position based on the nav link that you have clicked. Now let's take this UI design to next level. I just want to give that rounded corners around that bordered line as well. So for that, now you can just copy that class box and paste it down there. For our div class name class box, I want to give before and after pseudo element. And as you know, for each pseudo element, we need to give their content element. So I'm giving empty string. For the position, let's give absolute. And I want to give the width and height of 2 rem. And once again, you can duplicate that class box with before pseudo element. Okay, before that, for our before and after pseudo element, let's give the background color of this yellow green color. But later on, we'll remove this background color. But for now, just to show you what's really going on, I just want to keep it there. Now for our before pseudo element, let's give left of minus 2.5 rem. And border top right radius of 2 rem. So I'm giving the same width and height value. And also for our before and after pseudo element, let's give top value to 44%. It admin will be clearly visible. So let's zoom it. And now you can see we have given their position of absolute, but it's taking its parent element as class navbar because we have given their position of relative. So we need to give that proper relative position for our parent element. In our case, that is the class box. Now, for our before shoot element, you can give box shadow. For the x offset, I'm giving 0.14 rem. For the y offset, minus 0.8 rem. And for our blur value, let's give 0. And for the color, for now, I'm just giving yellow, but later on we'll change it, okay? Now you can duplicate this whole code. Instead of that before shoot class, let's give after. Now let's change that alt value, left to right, and vice versa. And also for our box shadow, for the x offset, let's give that negative 0.14 rem. In your browser now you can see this is the exact position of our element that I want. Now I just want to show you the magic. Let's change that yellow color to this CSS secondary variable. That means I'm giving the same background color that we have gave for our body element. And now you can remove that yellow green background color. In your browser, did you see that? What do you think? You can be more creative with this design, okay? What if I want to change that nav indicator background color something into that orange color? And now I need to change that icon's color as well, something into white. And in your browser now you can see you'll be able to get totally different design. But now you can see there is another problem. When you hover, you'll be able to change that icon's color, okay? So in order to prevent that, so now when you hover that anchor tag, you can give there another pseudo class not, and within that you can pass the class name active. Now in your browser, did you see that? That problem is solved. And also you can change that border radius of navbar as well. Something into this. What do you think about that? But I just love that previous design, so let's change it back to previous code. But as you can see, that curved line that is not clearly visible, so let's change that secondary color to this dark gray color. And in your browser now you can see you'll be able to clearly see that curved lines, and that looks really cool. So based on your color scheme, you can change that CSS color value, and that's it. And also I have added there extra one line of JavaScript code. So why am I doing that? Let me know in the comment box. Likewise, I have also created other different videos on interactive navigation bar. If you are interested, you can check it out in the description below where the video's link will be provided. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.